your makeup just so. Guess you don't know that you're beautiful. Try on every dress that you own. You were fine in my eyes a half hour ago. And if your mirror won't make it any clearer, I'll be the one to let you know. Out of all of the girls, you're my one and only girl. Ain't nobody in the world tonight. All of the stars, you make them shine like they rose. Ain't nobody in the world but you and I.
When your legs don't work like they used to before, and I can't sweep you off of your feet, will your mouth still remember the taste of my love? Will your eyes still smile from your cheeks? And darling, I will be loving you till we're 70, yeah. And baby, my heart could still fall as hard at 23. And I'm thinking about how people fall in love in mysterious ways, or maybe just the touch of a hand. Well, me, I fall in love with you every single day, and I just have to tell you I am. So honey, now take me into your loving arms. Kiss me under the light of a thousand stars. Place your head on my beating heart. Yeah, I'm thinking out loud that maybe we found love right where we are.
Please be seated. I have been a friend of Kayla and Katie for over 11 years now. We went to college together back when ball was life. We are gathered here today to share in a celebration of love and to join together forever the hearts of Katie and Kayla, two beautiful spirits sharing the most sacred and tender of human relationships. They've invited us all here today to rejoice, celebrate, eat, and bear witness to this sacred union. They stand before you bound by their love for each other and their desire to share the expression of their love with you and the whole wide world. We, their family and friends, form a community of love that together we may support and encourage them with our abundance of prayers and blessings on this day and for the rest of your lives. At this time, I ask that you all bow your head in prayer for a blessing of Katie and Kayla. May God bless and guide them on their journey together. May the Holy Spirit fill their hearts with unconditional love and understanding. May their continued kindness, compassion, trust, and faith in each other and in God be a constant example of the grace and beauty that the gift of love embodies for all of us. Amen. I'd like to share with you a reading by a gentleman by the name of Wilfred A. Peterson. And it's entitled, The Art of Marriage. This is definitely not a science. A good marriage must be created. In the art of marriage, the little things are the big things. It's never being too old to hold hands. It's remembering to say I love you every single day. It is never going to sleep angry. That one is difficult. It is having a mutual sense of values and common objectives. It is forming a circle of love that gathers in the entire family. It is speaking words of appreciation and demonstrating gratitude in thoughtful ways. It is having the capacity to not only forgive, but to forgive. It is giving each other an atmosphere in which you can nurture growth. It is finding room for the things of the Spirit. It's also a common search for the good and the beautiful in each other. And last but definitely not least, it's not only marrying the right partner, but more importantly, becoming the right partner. We come here today in a celebration and expression of love. Love is perhaps the greatest gift that God has ever given us. It is our inherent nature and our sole true purpose in life to love one another. Love provides us with the core sustenance of life. It nourishes our spirits and fuels our souls. Love compels us, motivates us, brings joy to our hearts, and truly is the essence of life. We can endure many things in the world, but without being able to share and feel love, our lives would be but an empty shell. When we are able to give and receive the gift of love, our life becomes full and energized and hopeful with unbounded possibilities. Love truly is the essence of life. These two people that you see standing here before you, their souls have made a commitment to each other to support and share a life together. This is not merely a verbal commitment, but a promise of the heart and soul of two human beings. Today is about love and about celebrating love's purpose and importance of our lives. In the presence of God, family, and friends, I ask you to state your intentions. I'm going to ask you guys a couple of questions. The response is going to be, I will. Katie and Kayla, have you come here freely and without reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage? Will you love and control? No. Will you love and honor each other as married partners for the rest of your lives? Do you, Kayla, take Katie to be your life partner? Your love and your best friend. Do you promise this day to share your life with her, to respect her, honor her, support and love her through life's challenges and celebrations? Will you stand by her side from this day and for all the days of your life? Do you, Katie, take Kayla to be your life partner, your love and your best friend? Do you promise this day to share your life with her, to respect, honor, support, and love her? Through life's challenges and celebrations, will you stand by her side from this day and for all the days of your life? With this ring, I commit myself to you.
With this ring, I commit myself to you.
And join my life with yours. All right. Katie, you have the ring. Place it on our finger. Repeat after me. Kayla, this ring I give you in token of my love and devotion. I pledge to you all that I am. With this ring, I myself to you. Enjoying my life with yours. Let me now kiss the bride. Now that you, Katie, and you, Kayla, have promised to give yourselves to one another and to love each other through your sacred vows and through the giving and receiving of these rings, it gives me great honor and pleasure to now pronounce to you the Grums.